Welcome to Tammy's Ripping Kitchen. Today I will be showing you how I make my pierogies. I use white potatoes, sweet potatoes, and a little bit of sauerkraut. And then I'll be making some cashew cream, and also may show you a little Caesar salad and also some carrot cake. Making a birthday dinner, so I will keep you filled in. Thanks for watching. So today I'll be showing you how I make my pierogies. I'm going to peel and cut my potatoes along with my sweet potatoes and get them boiling in the pot. And then I'll show you how I mash them up. All right, so now that I have all the potatoes peeled and the sweet potatoes, I'm just going to dice them up and then boil them. To make pierogies, just, you know, don't be rushed for time when you're making them, because it should be the fun of and the joy of making, right? Not just to get it done. I've always enjoyed making them. It is tedious, but it's sure worth it. All right, so we've got our potatoes already. Just gonna put some water in those babies. And then onto the stove we'll go. And then while the potatoes are boiling, I'm going to go get my KitchenAid. I wasn't sure if I was going to use my KitchenAid or my food processor for the dough. Actually, still not. Yeah, I don't know. Figure that out in a second. All right, so onto the stove they go. So the potatoes are starting to boil. Oh, and I did the cashews here, so I'm going to just pour the boiling water on them and let them soak for a while. So that's that. It's going to just go away. That. All right. going to do the dough, I did decide on using my handy dandy food processor. So in here, I'm going to add 3 cups of flour. This is just all-purpose flour. I don't normally make pierogies much anymore, so I'm not too concerned with the gluten-free for the amount that we really eat them. So there's the flour, 3 cups of flour. Here I've got 1 teaspoon of salt. And I'm just going to pulse that a little bit. And now I'm just going to slowly add in the water. And just put it on high and put it in the water. So that's why I just wrapped it in a towel there, and I'll let it sit for a little while I wait for my potatoes. So our potatoes are almost ready. Just wanted to come over here, so I've got some sauerkraut, parsley, salt, a little bit of garlic powder, nutritional yeast, pepper, and dill, and a little bit of butter, and then I'll be mashing those up. All right, so I've got the potatoes all ready. Smells amazing. Those spices. You want this just to be a nice fluffy consistency. You could use the mixer too to mash them, but I find this is adequate for pierogies. Probably waited to add that milk. You don't want it too creamy either. You want to keep it a little dry. It makes it a little easier to make the pierogies crispy. Potatoes and the sweet potatoes are so good together. When I have extra of this, I'll just eat it out of the bowl. We'll have to cool down a little bit. Just put it in the fridge. A couple minutes. So it's looking pretty good. A little bit more. Got the sweat. Alright. sauerkraut in here. Tininess. Alright, I just wanted to show you how I go about making my cashew cream. So I've got my cashews here all soaked and ready to go. Just gonna give them a little strain. And in here I have a quarter of a cup of almond milk and about 3/4 of a teaspoon of apple cider vinegar. Just gonna add the cashews in there. I've got a half a teaspoon of onion powder, half a teaspoon of garlic powder, and some salt and pepper. And now I am just going to put about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. I just bought this today. My last one broke, so I've been using one of the other types of lemon juicers. And then I'm just going to go run it up, and that will be our cashew cream for the perogies. If it's a little thick, I'll just add a little more water and keep it posted. So here we have the cashew cream. I did end up adding a little bit more water, and I squeezed out the rest of those lemons too to get a little more zesty. But this is how it turned out. Pretty good. It'll thicken up too once it's in the fridge. It's quite warm right now because I had to blend it for so long. So yeah, I definitely had to have more water. So that will be as part of my recipe that I put up for you guys. And there you have it, just a great bowl of cashew cream. Yummy. Alright folks, it's pierogi time. So a lot easier to work with. I just have half the dough and I just wrapped the other half up. This is what I put it in while it was sitting on the counter for that time. Just set that aside. Okay. So you're going to want to just sprinkle a little dough. Sorry. You want to just sprinkle a little flour on your surface. Work the dough a little bit till it gets nice and soft again. Go on top. And move it away. Just take a little bit of time because it is quite stretchy. So you just have to have patience. This is when it's nice to have that parchment paper so you're not all over the counter. So yes, I am wearing my Manifest Your Life shirt underneath my Ripping Kitchen apron. Manifest Your Life was by a girl who I've followed since I became vegan. Hot for Food, Lauren, and she's got another channel on Toyota, and also her Hot for Food. And honestly, for probably a good, at least the first year going vegan, I made so many of her recipes. I've got lots of pictures to come, just because I am wanting to do a video for you guys of how we transition to where we are today. I'm mostly raw now, but I do eat cooked food. But it has just been a transition, you know? Sometimes you can't give things up instantly, and that's okay, you know? Everyone's at a different place, and don't beat yourself up if you haven't been able to give something up yet. I think cheese was probably the last thing I gave up. I think I threw the last little bit I had away, actually, in my fridge. Parmesan cheese and some matzah. I believe those just went in the garbage. But yeah, don't beat yourself up if you're wanting to make a change and you still keep falling back. It'll come. You know, the little steps you take, the baby steps, really what counts. And it's going to make a big difference in your vegan transition. So I am stretching this out a little past the paper just because I do want it nice and thin, and it does stretch back. Alright. So, that's just still the black grain piece. So I think that feels about right. You can kind of tell by the thickness. Alright. Show you. Paper wants to move there, so anyway, you guys get the idea here. I'm just going to continue, make little circles. Doesn't have to be perfect. I'm going to turn this around here. Then I will put another towel over top of these while I work with them. Otherwise they will dry out. We can put that. Oh, nice and easy to work with. I don't want them sticking together, so make sure you don't put them on top of one another. Alright, so this still I'll just roll out after. I won't add it to the other one because it always already has been worked and I don't like to try to rework it into the dough. So just actually might be able to put that in there. And I'll cover these babies up. Keep that covered up. My air is quite dry in my house, so things honestly dry out really quick. So there you have it. There's the dough pieces, and we'll get filling. All right, so now we're going to get on to making these perogies. We're going to take about 3/4 of a teaspoon or so. Stretch the little shell before you put it on just a tiny bit. And you're gonna fold the edges over, stick that in, pinch them together, and kind of grab the edges. You can do see the filling coming out a bit. And there you go. go. Flour on them too, and then kind of pat it so they don't stick on the paper. So what I mean by pinching in the middle, there's the kind of form it a little bit there, and then you pinch that in the middle. So you've got that, push that in, and then you bring the pinches around. One more here for you guys, and then I'll sign off and show you the finished product after. This is really nice dough to work with, so I would highly recommend that. Oh, and speaking of pot for food, this is where I got the dough recipe. I don't follow the filling recipe exactly, just because that's what I do. I don't follow recipes really, but yeah, there's So before the frying step, you boil some water and put the pierogies in, and when they're floating at the top, then you put them in your frying pan. You can fry with a little coconut oil or butter, whichever you choose. I like topping them with a little dill, maybe some coconut bacon, and of course your cashew cream.